way means using your existing resources such as savings or cash flow from other source of income to start your business. You're welcome. My name is Mubashir Salahuddin. So today we're going to be discussing on three major ways on how you can raise your startup capital. Startup capital are important for your business, just as blood and oxygen are important to your body. There are lots of ways that you can actually raise your startup capital with, but there are three major ways which I have put together and I'm going to be sharing with you today. So without wasting much of our time, let's dive straight into it. So the first way you can raise your startup capital with is bootstrapping from savings or freelancing cash flow. Bootstrapping here means self-funding. So the first way means using your existing resources such as savings or cash flow from other source of income to start your business. It is important to use this kind of cash flow to start your business because we believe that if you use your personal money to start your business, you're going to put more seriousness in it in order to make the business succeed. And if by any means the business did not go as you planned, that means the business did not succeed, then you won't start to worry about paying the money to anybody. All you need to do is to just dust yourself up, pick up your plan and start again, or go and start doing something else. So the next way that you can use in getting your startup capital is securing a credit or getting a loan from financial institution. Normally when it comes to funding for entrepreneur, what usually comes to mind is bank. Taking loan can be a good thing, but you need to be sure that your business will succeed at first try. Although it depends on the kind of business that you want to go into, that will determine if you're going to get the loan in the first place or if you should even get the loan at all. But you need to also consider that if the interest rate of the loan will be favorable to you or not, and if you will be able to comply with the terms and conditions of the loan before even taking the loan. The third way here is raising capital from others. These others are same set of people that you can get money from. So the first others here is family and friends. These are people that you actually have direct relationship with and you have more influence over them. So let's say you've gathered your money from bootstrapping and it is still not enough for you to start your business from. You can turn to them, or they are even the first people you're going to come to for your startup capital. See, let's forget about you have a direct relationship with them, or don't use that as an advantage. Make sure you take every single penny you take from these people serious by making it professional. Write everything down in order to ensure repayment back. So the next way others here is crowdfunding. This is how crowdfunding work for entrepreneurs. As an entrepreneur, you put together the description of your business, such as the goals of your business, how you intend to make profits from your business, the products of your business, and etc. etc. You put it on a crowdfunding platform. Then consumers go there and read about what you've put there. So if anybody likes the idea, they will simply make a pledge to you by either by saying they are pre-ordering your products. So when you start running your business, you would need to be giving them the products that they pre-order for, while others will just give the money in form of donation. The next order here is angel investor, and these are set of individuals with high net worth. They actually invest in people's business and startup businesses with the intention of getting share of the business. That you have to have share in your business. Some, let's say for example, they will say, okay, they want to go into business with you, but they will have to have 40% of your business, 20% of your business. So they would want to claim share of your business. The last order here is venture capitalists. These are a set of people that invest in business that are slightly more mature than that of angel investors. And they don't just want to invest in your business to get share, but they also want to form part of the running of your business, that the day-to-day running of your business. They want to know about it and contribute to the running of your business as well. So let's take a quick highlight before we go. So the first step is bootstrapping from savings or freelancing cash flow. The second way is securing a credit or getting a loan from financial institution. While the third way is raising your capital through others, such as family and friends, crowdfunding, angel investor, and venture capitalists. Unless you're a millionaire, getting your startup capital will require a serious plan and effort. And you should know by now that there are a lot of ways that you can actually get your startup capital from. So you need to go through all these ways that I've mentioned and look which one would be well okay for your business and for yourself, so you can select from. So thank you and see you next time. I hope this really helps you. So thank you and see you next time. Bye.